Hey there, Janet LeBlanc with Paper and Spark. In this video, I will be walking you through how to import in your Shopify sales CSV to your Paper and Spark Shopify Seller Spreadsheet or your Shopify import add-on. In my example here, I will be using the Shopify Seller Spreadsheet, but the instructions work exactly the same if you're using the Shopify import add-on. You're just not going to see all of these extra expense category tabs and rows if you're using the import add-on because you have those over on your main seller spreadsheet. But both of those types of files will have these blank CSV tabs that you're going to copy and paste the CSV into, which is what you'll see me do. I also want to note that these instructions will work whether you're using a basic or a more advanced type of Shopify account. All versions of Shopify plans have access to the CSV that I'll be using, so don't worry about that. You'll see me poke around in a basic Shopify plan account, so that's what I'll be using. And if for any reason your Shopify dashboard looks different than what you see on the video, make sure you go check out the Google Doc instructions because sometimes those get updated more quickly when there are aesthetic changes to the back end of Shopify. So what I'm going to import in is going to be everything that is a light blue row here on my monthly summary tab. That's going to be my Shopify sales, including sales tax collected. That's going to be the shipping amounts that my customers pay me and any partial or full refunds that I issue to my customers. We're going to import that in. Doing this one import, which is a copy and paste, is also going to bring in some sales tax collected information here. Here in my sales by state over on this rather hideous, overwhelming looking orange tab. So it's going to give me some sales tax information too. The first thing I want to do is log into my Shopify admin account for my shop. So once I am on like this main homepage from my Shopify seller account, I'm going to click on analytics over here. Then I'm going to select reports. Then I'm going to see this big kind of overwhelming list of reports. You want to look for the report called total sales. It is going to be one of these finances reports. So it may be hard to see at first. Everybody's in a different order and I use this one quite frequently. So Shopify puts it at the top. If you don't see it at the top though, just scroll to make sure you can see finance types of reports and you're looking for the one called total sales. You may have your categories turned to where you don't see everything. So make sure you can see the finances categories. So I'm going to click on total sales. And then I'm going to change my dates up here in the upper left corner. So I'm going to start with January 1st through January 31st and hit apply. Once I've filtered for the month that I want to do, I can hit this export button over here. I want to make sure that full report is selected, not just current page. Then I can click export and it's going to download as a CSV file on my computer. I'm going to go over to my downloads folder and then I'm going to open that with Excel, which is what I'm working in. If you're using Google Sheets, some people have trouble uploading their CSVs. So I've got a video for that if you need it. Now we've got all of our transactions for the month of January in here. Now what I want to do is copy this and paste it into my January import tab, this light blue tab over here. So to copy it, there's a couple different ways you can do it. You can click and drag down and select all of this if you want, but I think the easiest way to do it is just click this weird triangle box looking thing in the upper left corner. That will highlight all the data here. And then I can either right click copy, or I can do control C, or I can go to the edit menu and hit copy, whatever floats your boat. Once it's copied, I see this dancing ants marquee around my data. Then I can go over to January. It's a blank tab here first. Make sure I'm in cell A1. Okay, I'm scrolled all the way over to the left. So I see column A here. That placement is important. I'm going to click the cell A1 and now I can click paste or control V or edit paste. Again, they all do the same thing. So I've just copied and pasted that CSV in here. I can go over to my monthly summary tab and now I see amounts populating from my Shopify sales, my shipping received from my customers and any refunds. And it's hard to see here, but this refund is imported in as a negative number. See that little minus sign there? So it is lowering my sales revenue. And this is my total revenue for the month of January. This is how you import in your CSV and your sales information from Shopify. I'm looking at another set of example data here, but I just want to note a few things before we move on to how to find your Shopify fees in the next video. You always want to make sure that the numbers that you import in look reasonable. If anything looks wonky or unexpected or looks like it's not populated in the proper place, the first thing to do is just make sure that you pasted whatever in the right columns. And that means starting with column A for sure. Sometimes we forget to scroll all the way over and we start in a different column. That's okay. If you think that you pasted the CSV in wrong, your best bet is to just hit undo until you get back to the point before you pasted it in and then try again. A couple of brief notes about what you import in. Like I said, that will bring in your total Shopify sales from all sources. So however someone checks out on your Shopify site, all those sales will be included here. Shopify payments, Shop Pay, that's the same thing. PayPal, Klarna, Sezzle, installment plans, Apple Pay, however they can pay you on your shop site or through your Shopify card reader, but if you have a point of sale reader, it will be included here. It also includes sales tax that you actually collected from your customer. And it will include what you charge your customer for shipping because that is part of your revenue. One thing I do want to note, if you are using a Shopify point of sales card reader, like at in-person events and people are swiping it, it will show up here, but it's going to leave the billing and shipping state on your CSV blank, which will impact whether those sales are imported in for sales tax purposes. It's not going to know the state of the sale, so it's not going to know to bring in those sales tax collected. I have a little note about that over here on the Google Doc instructions. So just note that sales that are processed with the Shopify point of sale card reader has the state info blank on that imported CSV. If you need to have that by state sales information, that sales tax collected for your state sales tax forms, you want to go in and manually type in the state into that shipping state column of your CSV so that you can get the accurate in-state sales totals you need. This will make more sense once we cover how the blue sales tax tab works. I just want to note it here so that you're aware. All right, let's move on to how to find and enter your Shopify fees.